for the most part, these fights are incredibly easy at this moment. But I guess that's good for us, since I won't look stupid having to, like, decide what to do and reading everything.
So much for the element of
preemptive strike. They were, like, looking directly at us, man. Item usage tutorial. I already know how to use items. We'll skip it. Items pretty much just use it. That's all. It uses it right away without even expending your active time battle, I think. Okay, so I should start explaining. They haven't explained it yet, but the top right, sometimes when it comes up, like when it comes up on their target right now, you see it says like 100%, sometimes like 200%. I believe that's the amount of damage you do to them. And if you could get that whole bar to fill up all the way, they stagger, which causes you to do constant critical hits after that point. Looks like we're having another Midgar incident here.
Turn back?
There's no time.
Oh, smoke.
What do you suggest we do?
Quiet.
Oh, here we go. Lightning's gonna... Maybe... Maybe...
Hey! Wait! No, no! Don't leave me!
Let go!
No, hell no! You're my only way out of here! Hey, that might get us across. Right there.
So I assume that's a temporary power that she has. An explanation of that might come later in the story, and I'm pretty curious about that. I wonder if she's like some kind of genetically modified soldier, like Cloud, and then, you know, maybe that's Mako energy.
All right, you leave this to me.
Mako, make it Mako. That sound that keeps happening—it's like shh. Sounds like Charge from World of Warcraft when you play a warrior. I love how the battles are very seamless, almost. They're not 100% seamless, but they're fairly seamless in how it runs. You don't have like 10 seconds or 20 seconds before you start fighting. See, that guy staggered and now he says 203%, so you're doing 203% damage to him. Guess we should use a potion. Whoa. Potion seems really effective at this point. What would you do if you ran out though? I assume you'll get healed later, like cure. Stagger, alright. Let's check what the other item was. Oh, it's the Phoenix Down. Well, we have 18 potions. I don't think we're gonna run out of that. Alright. Just check up here.
Work in order.
Take a look. Take a look, see. Aha. Wow, there's a lot of save points. Let's take a look at the shop while we're here. I mean, we're... Unicorn Mart. Buy. Potions, Phoenix Down. Wow! Phoenix Down is 1,000 gil. So we can't really do anything. Oh. Oh, those are equipped. Components, Wicked Fang, Chip Fang. I guess, assume those are for maybe some kind of profession in the game. Not sure. Not sure yet. Not sure yet. Activate. Not sure what we're activating here, but... Control panel. Randomly pressing buttons. Heading on to the other platform. Platform of joy. Alright. I think we might be coming up to a boss fight soon.
Weapons down.
Whoa, what the hell is that?
Turn ugly?
He wants to kill us without a fight.
Time's up!
Okay. Seems like we got a mini-boss, I guess? Attack chain tutorial. I think we might need to watch this one. Initiate an attack chain. First select auto battle or attack from the abilities menu. Now let's try to choose attack. And then attack again. See the bar displayed beneath your target's name? Yeah. That is known as a chain gauge. Keep an eye on the chain gauge as you strike. Oh, that's basically the stagger gauge. Yeah, I think I know what it's getting at. I assume it would go up faster while using a chain gauge is full gauge. Dodge gauge. You do a lot more damage. Look for another blitz here. Might have to use a potion in a bit. Just gonna use one right now. Yeah, I went for a blitz there. Manual blitz, although I assume it might have done a manual automatic blitz right away anyway. Oh, it did. Okay, it's going for another attack. Blitz. Alright, another blitz, let's go. Alright, effective. Nice. Phoenix down.
So, soldier. What's your angle? What? Classified military info? Huh? What's the matter? You quit, didn't you? Did you think I'm gonna go out there and just tell everybody your secrets?
See. My angle. I'm after the foul sea.
What? After the foul sea. So there's foul sea and lust sea. So we're gonna find out what the difference between the two are.
Still happy you tagged along.
I'm not gonna try and. I don't actually know anything, so I can't really spoil anything.
Didn't have a choice.
I guess that's a good thing. I mean, we're playing this blind. Didn't have a choice, I had to survive. Look at me, I got two guns, you're fighting people with a sword and doing more damage. Yeah, big time. I mean, he's doing like, what, 6-7 damage? I'm doing like 40? 60?
I'd like to thank our brave pioneers and express our best wishes for a successful relocation. Your noble and selfless sacrifice ensures the continued safety and peace of our society. Were it not for this remarkable gesture, every resident of Cocoon, your family, your friends, your neighbors, would be exposed to the dangers of the world below. By choosing to leave Cocoon and participating in this migration...
Migration? More like extermination.
Huge. You stay here.
Looks like we got some new characters here.
Sorry. I didn't mean to.
And
these people need heroes.
What, huge luge?
Here. You keep your cool, and they will too. You got it?
Got it. What's our motto?
It's like the Big Brother.
The army's
the Big
no
Brother
match
situation.
That a boy.
Nora. I'm guessing Nora might be the rebellion group that this guy is leading. Possibly. The Resistance Front. Hanging Edge. Hanging Edge? Hanging on the Edge? So it looks like we're playing with this guy now. And I just saw a button. An item here. But we'll continue on with Snow right after this on the next episode of Final Fantasy XIII. Keep in touch, or stay tuned, rather.